Hi, welcome to Digital Principles and System Design. In this video lecture, we will discuss about Boolean algebra and what is its role in digital logic design. As we have already discussed, any digital logic circuit will have the input and output in binary number system. That is, the input and outputs are going to be zeros and one. When we represent the zeros and ones with variables, we want rules and regulations to govern how this Boolean expressions will operate. So Boolean algebra is the solution or the guidelines or the laws which will govern the manipulation of Boolean expressions. We use Boolean algebra to simplify the Boolean expressions. And why we need to simplify the Boolean expression? Because we wanted to simplify the digital logic design. Okay, so given a Boolean expression, if we implement the Boolean expression as such, we will end up with the complicated design of the circuit. Whereas if we simplify the complicated expression with Boolean algebra, with the laws of the Boolean algebra, we get a simpler design, that is the simplified Boolean expression. When we realize this simplified expression as the digital logic circuit, we will have a simplified circuit which will have the benefit of the cost. That is, when we implement the circuit with simplified expression, the number of gates required to implement the circuit will be less. That means that the cost involved in the production of the circuit will be minimized. It is worth to note that the result of the circuit, whether we implement the original one or the simplified one, will be the same. Here the number of gates will be more and here the number of gates will be less. But whatever be the combination of the input, both the circuits are going to give the same result. So we normally use the Boolean algebra to simplify any given expression and see if we can eliminate some of the terms and that will lead to the simpler design of the logic circuit. And the simplification is based on the postulates of the Boolean algebra, the basic properties and the theorems involved in the Boolean algebra. Like any other algebraic structure, the Boolean algebra is also defined on a set with two elements, which is 0 and 1. And we have set of operations defined over these sets, which is logical OR operator and this is logical AND operation. And the variables in the Boolean algebra will be represented either in its original form or in the complemented form. That is, if I use a variable A, if I simply write it as A, this is in the original form, and if we use the complement, it is in the complement form. Now we will see some of the postulates of Boolean algebra. The first postulate is the closure. That is, the Boolean system is closed under the Boolean operators, the logical operator OR and logical operator AND. What do you mean by closed? If I apply these operations over the members of the set B, then the result will also be in the same set. That is, if we apply the logical OR operator, say for example, if I say 1 OR 1, the result is 1, which is also in the same set. If we apply the AND operation, say 1 AND 0, the result is going to be 0, which is also in the same set. So this is the meaning of closed. That is, when you apply the operations on any of the elements of the set B, the result will also be in the same set. Next postulate is the identity element. The identity element with respect to the plus operator or the logical OR operator is 0, and the identity element with respect to the AND operation is 1. What do you mean by identity element? When we operate any variable with the identity element of that operator, the result is going to be that variable itself. That is, A or 0 is A. That is, A can take any value. Suppose if A takes 1, 1 or 0 is going to be 1, which is the value of A. If A takes the value of 0, then 0 or 0 is 0, which is again the value of A. Okay. Similarly, we can compute for A and 1 is equal to A. Okay. If A takes the value of 1, the result is going to be 1. If A takes the value 0, the result is going to be 0, because 0 and 1 is going to be 0. The next is the commutative law. The commutative law says A or B is equal to B or A. That is, you can change, even if you change the order of the operands, the result is going to be the same. And with respect to the AND operation, A and B is equal to B and A. Here we change the order of the operands. Okay, the operation remains the same because we have a single operation. In associative law, we are going to change the order of the operation. Okay, here it says A or B or C is equal to A or B or C. When you use brackets, okay, the first operation that you are going to perform is this B or C. The result of this operation, we are going to OR it with A. Now, if you change the order of operation, instead of performing B or C first, we are performing A or B first, and then the result of this, we are going to OR it with C. Okay, even if you change the order of the operation, the result is going to be the same. The associative law with AND operation is A and B and C is equal to A and B and C. Here the order of operands are the same, but we change the order of the operation. Next is the distributive law. The distribution of R over AND operation is A or B and C is equal to A or B and A or C. Okay, why we call this as distribution of R over AND? Because here there is only one R operation. Here we have distributed it. We have two R operation over this AND operation. And the distribution of AND operation over R operation is A and B or C is equal to A and B or A and C. The next is the complement. For every element in the set B, there exists a unique complement, which is called A complement, such that A or A complement is equal to 1 and A complement equal to 0. So here this is the identity of the AND operation, and 0 is going to be the identity of the OR operation. So when you perform A or A complement, we get 1. For example, if A takes the value 1, A complement is going to be 0, right? So the R between 1 and 1 or 0 is going to be 1. Similarly, if A takes the value 0, A complement will be 1. So 0 or 1 will be again 1. Here also, when A takes the value 1, A complement is going to be 0. When you make AND between these two inputs, the result is going to be 0. And if A is 0, A complement will be 1. So again, the AND between 0 and 1 will be 0. Next, we will see an important property called the duality or duality principle, which says that if an expression is valid in Boolean algebra, its dual is also valid. What do you mean by dual? I can obtain the dual of an expression by replacing all OR operation with AND operation and vice versa. That means that I have to replace all AND operations with OR operations and replacing all ones with zeros and vice versa. That is all zeros with ones. Other variables will remain as such. For example, consider the distributive law, which is A OR B and C equal to A OR B and A OR C. Now we will have the variables as such, but we will replace the plus with dot and dot with plus. Okay, and we can get the dual of the distributive law. Okay, so we'll replace this plus with dot and this dot with plus, plus with dot. Okay, so we know that this is distributive law, which is distribution of plus over dot. When we obtain the dual, we get the distributive law of dot over plus. Next, we will discuss about the theorems of Boolean algebra. The first theorem is the idempotent law, which is very useful in simplification. If we have x or x, the result is going to be x. That is, when we have many expressions with many duplicates, I can remove all the duplicates and have only one expression of the duplicates. So when we have x, so suppose if x is 1, when you OR it with 1 again, the result is going to be 1. So it is again x. If x is 0, when you OR it with 0, the result is going to be 0. So we can have the same x as the result. Okay, so x or x is going to be x. If you apply the duality, I'll have x and x equal to x. Okay, here also when you AND 1 with 1, you will get 1. When you AND 0 with 0, you will get 0. So this is idempotent law, which is very useful in simplification. Next theorem is the null element. So when you have x or 1, the result is going to be 1. That is, you are nullifying the effect of the variable involved in the Boolean expression. So when x is 1, when you have R1, okay, any one of the inputs, even if any one of the inputs is 1, the result is going to be 1 for R operation. So the result is going to be 1. If x is 0, then again with this 1, the result is going to be 1. So the x does not influence the result of this expression. And when you apply the duality principle, you get x and 0 is equal to 0. We will replace this plus with dot and 1 with 0, right? So we get x and 0 is going to be 0 always, irrespective of the value of x. So this is the null element, because this 0 nullifies the effect of x in the expression. Next theorem is involution. X complement the whole complement. That is, x double complement is simply x. Okay, why? If x is say 0, if you complement it, we get 1. The complement of 0 is 1. And when you complement 1 again, which is this one, okay, so x is 0. When you perform complement, we got 1. When you wanted to complement it again, we will get 0 again, okay, which is the same x we started with. If x is 1, okay, when you complement it, we get 0, and when you complement it again, we get 1, which is the same x we started with. This is involution. The next theorem is redundancy. If we have A or A complement and B, we get A or B as the result. The dual of this expression is A and A complement or B is equal to A and B. We'll prove this expression why it is so. we have A or A complement B, the left hand side of this expression. We are going to use the distributive law, distribution of plus over dot. Okay, we get A or A complement and, okay, here I haven't explicitly specified the AND operation. Even if you don't specify it, there is a AND between this expression and this expression. So again, we will have A or B as the second sub expression. Now from the complement, so we are using the distributive law. Now using the complement theorem, which is A or A complement is equal to 1, we can reduce this to 1. Okay, we are using the complement, postulate complement. And now we know that 1 and A or B is equal to A or B because this is the postulate of identity element. And we know that 1 is the identity element of AND operation. So 1 into A or B equal to A or B. Okay, so this is one way of proving it using the Boolean laws. We are simplifying the expression. The other way to prove is to use the truth table. We have A, B, two variables involved in this expression. So we have listed A and B with all possible inputs that A and B together can take. And now we have A complement in the left hand side of the expression. So we compute A complement from this one, and now we compute A complement and B. So we have A complement and B, we can simply make between these two and list out. Then we have A or A complement B. Okay, already we have found out A complement B. Now we have to just do A or this column. Okay, we need not recompute this one. We have to simply say A or this column. We will get this result, and then the right hand side is A or B. So we can perform A or B and list out here. So if you observe this column and this column, we find for any combination of inputs for A and B, we get the same result for A or B, A complement and B, and A or B, that is the left hand side and right hand side of this redundancy theorem. Similarly, you can establish that the dual of this is also true. Next is the De Morgan's theorem, one of the important theorems. We repeatedly use this in simplification. We get A or B, the whole complement is equal to A complement and B complement. The dual of this is A and B, the whole complement is equal to A complement or B complement. We can use the truth table to establish this relationship. We have two variables in this expression, A and B. So we have A and B, and we have listed out all possible combinations of inputs for both A and B. A and B taking 0, 0, 0 and 1, 1 and 0 and 1 and 1. Now we have A or B. So we have computed A or B using this one. And A or B, the whole complement will be just the complement of the third column. And in the right hand side, we have A complement. We have A here. We can obtain the A complement just by flipping the bits of A. Similarly, we can obtain the B complement from the column of B by flipping the inputs of B. And then we can compute A complement and B complement using the columns of A complement and B complement. And if you observe the left hand side, which is A or B, the whole complement, we have got 1 and the rest of the outputs, okay, are going to be 0. And similarly, A complement and B complement, we get the same result. Thereby, we establish the left hand side as equal to the right hand side for all possible combinations of the inputs for both A and B. Recall that when we discussed the Boolean logic, we said that the NAND gate and the NOR gate are universal gates, and we use the De Morgan's law here. Okay, it is X bar, Y bar, the whole bar. Okay, which is x plus y. So how we get this one? We get like when we apply the De Morgan's law, we get like x bar the whole bar plus some y bar the whole bar. Okay, and we can use the involution theorem to get this x double bar is equal to x and y double bar equal to y. But to get this x bar y bar the whole bar, we use the De Morgan's theorem. Similarly, here also we apply the De Morgan's law, x bar or y bar the whole bar, we get x bar y bar like this. Okay, x bar is one element, its bar, and y bar is one element, its bar. That is the result. Again, we can use the involution to get x and y to be the result of x bar or y bar the whole bar. Next is the absorption theorem. This is also one of the important theorems, and we use this in simplification. A or A and B equal to A. Okay, we have completely eliminated the operations. Okay, and one variable, and we have reduced this expression to A. The dual of this expression is A and A or B equal to A. Okay, let's prove this expression A or A and B equal to A. So we take the left hand side and we use the identity element and multiply this A with 1. Okay, when we multiply any element, or when we say multiply, we actually mean the AND operation. When we AND any variable with 1, we get the same variable. So I can use the identity element postulate and say A AND 1 or A AND B. Now I can use the distributive law. Okay, this is the right hand side of the distributive law of dot over plus. So we can reduce this with the left hand side of the distributive law. So we get A and 1 or B. Okay, so we are using the distributive law. Now we can use the null element theorem to eliminate the influence of this B, because this expression is always going to be 1. So I can write it as A and 1. Again, we can use the identity element and say A and 1 is equal to A. We can use the truth table also to prove this one. We have A or A and B. Okay, we should compute A and B and then use A or A and B to get this one. And if you observe the result of this, this is the same as that of this A. So the left hand side and the right hand side are the same. Thereby we establish A or A and B equal to A. Similarly, this you can establish using the truth table, or you can simplify using the Boolean laws. Now we will see how we can use the Boolean laws to simplify an expression and how that results in the cost effective circuit. Suppose if the expression is x and x bar plus y, we can simplify this. So we can use the distributive law and write this as x and x bar or x or y using the distributive law, and then we know that this x and x bar is equal to 0 using the complement postulate. Now this term is as such. Now 0 or any expression will be the same expression using the identity element. So we get x and y as the result. Okay, so this is the simplified expression, and we call this x and y as f2. Now we have established the simplification using the truth table as well. We have x y two variables involved in this. We have computed the f1, which is x and x bar y. We have used the values of x and y. We have computed x bar and then we have applied the logics and we have arrived at this one. And now we compute simply x and y, and we see that this expression and this expression gives the same result for all the combinations of x and y. If we implement the circuit using the expression given in F1, okay, we have to obtain x complement first. So we will to get the complement, we will use the NOT operator or the NOT gate. So what we get here is x bar, and then this x bar we are going to OR it with y. So we use a OR gate to obtain this sub expression x bar OR y here, and the result of this has to be AND with x. Okay, so we use a AND gate. So one operand is this result of the OR operation that comes from the OR gate, and the other input is this x. Okay, so this is F1, and we can implement the same logic using the simplified expression, which is simply the x and y. I use a simple AND gate and obtain the expression F2, and we have already seen that F1 and F2 are computing the same function for all combinations of inputs of x and y. So what is the benefit that we derive out of this simplification? Here we are using three gates, one NOT gate, one OR gate and one AND gate. Here we simply use one AND gate to get the result for the same operation. Okay, so the cost of developing this circuit will be more, so we don't prefer this circuit, and this circuit is cheaper because we use less number of gates, so we prefer the simplified circuit. Let's see another example. Here F1 is x complement y complement z, or x complement y z, or x y complement. When we simplify this, we see that x complement z is common in the first two elements. So we can take out this x complement z, and what we are left with is y complement or y. So we have actually used the distributive law here. Now we can use the complement postulate to say this y complement or y is going to be simply 1. Okay, so 1 into x complement z. Okay, the identity law, we will just result in x complement z, and this xy complement is as such in the expression. So let's call this simplified expression as F2. So we can use the truth table, okay, to verify that this F1 and F2 are indeed computing the same output for all combinations of the input. Since there are three variables, okay, x, y and z, okay, we have listed out x, y and z, and we have listed all possible combinations of input for all the three x, y and z. We have computed F1 and F2, and we have seen that for any input, the output for F1 and F2 are going to be the same. Okay, thereby we established that this F1 and the simplified expression F2 are computing the same function for any of the input x, y and z. If we realize the circuit using the F1 expression, we have the OR operation. The input to the OR operation we get from three sub expressions. So we have a single OR operator with three inputs, and the inputs to the OR operator are coming from these three sub expressions, which has to be computed using the AND operation, because we have three variables here and we have to perform the AND between x complement, y complement and z, and again AND between x complement y and z, and here we have AND between x and y complement. So we use three AND gate, and the first AND gate we should supply the x complement. So x complement we obtain by passing it through the NOT gate. So what we have here is x complement. Similarly, y, we have y complement here. So it is x complement, y complement, and z is coming as such. So what we have here is actually x complement, y complement, and z. And here we have x complement, we have one input to the AND gate, and the other input is the y. So we get y here, we get x complement here, and then we get z here. Okay, z is coming here. So the we multiply all the three, or we AND all the three, and we get the product here. And here we supply x is coming here. Okay, we get x here, and then we get the y complement from this line, and we get x y complement. So all these are fed to the OR gate to realize F1. Now the simplified expression of F1 is F2. Here we have x complement z. So we have z x complement is coming here. So we have x complement here, and z is here, and then we have x coming here, and then this is going to be y complement. Okay, and we pass, we obtain x complement z using this AND gate, and x y complement using this AND gate. We pass the result of the AND to the OR gate to obtain the expression F2. And see the complexity of these two circuits. Here we just use two AND gates, and both the AND gates are going to have only two inputs and one OR gate, and the number of inputs to the OR gate is also one. OR gate is two. Here we are using one OR gate, but the number of inputs is three, and here we use three AND gates instead of two AND gates. And out of the three AND gates, we use two AND gates with three inputs. Okay, so the cost of this circuit is more compared to the simplified circuit. Okay, so and this circuit is cost effective, and we prefer the simplified design for mass production. Finally, a recap of what we have seen in the introduction. We use the Boolean algebra to simplify the Boolean expression, thereby we get the simplified logic design. And we want the simplified logic design for cost effective mass production. And when we use Boolean laws to simplify the Boolean expressions, okay, there is no standard rule, okay, or no standard guidelines like which rule has to be applied after what rule. Okay, so when you apply the laws in different sequence, we might end up with two different expressions, and there is no guarantee that we will get one unique final answer. Okay, so in the next video we will see some standard systematic procedure how to simplify a given Boolean expression. Thank you for watching this video.